Welcome to another session. In the last video, we had seen the basic concepts of assortment. What are the types of assortment and what is the functionality of assortment and what are the ways of creating an article and listing them through the assortment functionality. Okay. So the basic ways we had seen is like one is creation of assortment module, assigning the material to the assortment module and assigning the module to the assortment. In this way, you are creating a link between the article and the assortment. And the second way is directly assigning the article to the assortment. And third one is automatic generation of assortment modules through the various functionalities like promotion. And fourth one is the generation of listing conditions through the layout functionalities. Okay. In this video, we are going to see the basic functionalities like creation of assortment module and assigning the articles to the module and assigning the module to the assortment. So in that way, you are creating a link between the article and the assortment. And the second way we are going to see is direct assignment of article to the assortment. For that, let us create a couple of articles, because many materials are having the listing conditions already. So let me 67, let me create it as a trading goods. This belongs to ACDS. Okay, and it's a single article. Let me select all the values. So today Telugu, it's the new blockbuster and the floor. So created that 02 and the price is okay. I have literally copied the same thing. So only thing I have to make change is the article description. Similarly, let me create one more article. This time, let it be a Tamil one. It's from the same music director and team. Logistics DC, Logistics Store, POS. So we have created two articles, 10072 and 73. Okay. So let us create a new assortment first. Okay. So logistics, retailing, master data, assortment and listing, assortment. First, let me create an assortment module. So we have many modules, many types of modules. One is the standard module, which says whatever article you have entered into this module is relevant for being purchased or sold in the particular site. Okay, exclusion module says like you cannot buy or sell this particular material. Rag jobber module is a functional separate functionality by itself, where the vendors place the material at the stores. Even though the material is physically present in your location or premise, it is not your inventory, it is not your property. Okay, it is still the property of the vendor. So at the end of the day, when the material is sold, and the vendor pays you a certain commission for each transaction. That is the rag jobber module. Fourth one is a value contract module. This functionality is available in the standard sales and distribution for value contracts, where you group a set of materials saying that if the customer buys materials from this module to a certain value, so that is the value contract. Okay, so now we are going to use the standard module. Okay, so before that, let me create the maintain the sales prices for this material 10072 and 10073, because you will get an error saying that sales price is not maintained. So for that side W001303. Slowly, slowly, everybody is getting a peek of the functionalities that are going to come. Okay, we haven't still discussed about the pricing functionality yet, but we are seeing similarly what happened earlier for the listings. So by this time you learnt about this listing concept, it had already become a familiar concept for you. WSO1. Okay, I am creating a standard module. So in this module, let me maintain that 10072. Okay, I intentionally am adding only one article to this module. Okay, and now we have created the module, so we can add any number of article in that. Now this module has to be assigned to an assortment. Okay, so let me create a general assortment. Audio. Okay, WW01 and W2. Okay, what is the listing procedure? What is the merchandise category? You can add all the merchandise category of the materials that you are going to assign to this through the modules. Okay, at this moment we are adding I am adding only one material, audio CD material. Okay, and here I have to add what are all the stores that can handle this material. So W100, W101, W102, W103 and W104. So when I am linking that article to this assortment through that module, it finally means that article 10072 can be bought and sold only in these materials 100 to 104. Create job without parameter control, immediate, check and save it. Okay, now you have created an assortment module. We have created an assortment. Now both have to be linked. So go to module, assortment assignment, maintain. So this is the assortment we have created. And there is an option called list the supplying site. What happens is, like, if you go to any site master, we might have maintained the link of supplying site, which means what are all the distribution centers that can supply to this particular store. Okay, so when you are listing this article to the stores, the system gives you an option of listing the article to this site's general assortment. So what do you mean by that? Which means this sites or DCs, they can buy that material and supply to the store. For that functionality, there is an inbuilt capability to automatically list the material to the supplying DCs. So that is maintained, that is enabled in your assortment module to assortment assignment. If you want, you can check it or you can uncheck it so that you can maintain the listing of the materials to the DCs separately in a different transaction or with a different assortment. So let me uncheck it. So what is that assortment? WWTELAUD, Telugu audio. So if I enable this, let us say like the assortment module has 100 articles, out of which only 30 articles have the DC also maintained as the internal vendor. Okay, if that is the case, if I enable this checkbox, the system will list only the 30 articles that has the internal DC or internal vendor assignment. So let me uncheck it, save it. Now what it means, the article 10072 is linked to the sites W100 to W104 through this assortment module. So now let us check the assortment table WLK1. What is our article? 100072. It is now available with this assortment. So what are all the assortment uses? W100 to 104. Now let me try to create a sales order to check whether the listing has been successful. W100072 10 pieces W100, yes, 1072 W101, yes, 1072 10 pieces to the site W110. It says the site, the material is not listed. It's not listed in the site because in that assortment user we had added the sites W100 to 104 only. So which means this article is can be bought and sold only in those five sites. So let me remove that. 1072. I'm checking for the listed sites, supplying sites. Yes, it still gives you error because when I am maintaining that assignment, I had said that I had unchecked the list supplying sites. So that is why you are getting this error, article not maintained in the site. Okay. So this is how you create a listing condition through the assortment module and the assortment. So this is one way of creating the assortments. The other way is creating the individual article listing against the assortment directly. Per assortment create. So my article, other article is 10073. Okay. So here also I have this option of unchecking it, listings created. So let me check the WLK1 table, SE16N, WLK1, article. You could say it is assigned to this assortment. So one article 72 was assigned to this assortment through the module. Sorry. The other article is assigned through this directly and it automatically creates a assortment module. Okay, and you can see the status. So whether it is assigned through any module or it is assigned directly without any reference. So the status says C, which means this is the individual listing without reference to a module. Now we have created these two materials, but they are not assigned to any DCs. Okay. Now I want to buy the material through the DCs. I don't want to place the PO directly. So I want to list this material to at least one DC. So what I can do, I can go to this WSP4 and I can maintain the site's local assortment. 72 is created, 73 is created. I am creating for 72 also. Now I have manually assigned this material to the local assortment W001. Okay. Now let me try to create a sales order for this material to be purchased from this site W001 10072 10 pieces W001. Yes, it allows 100073 10 pieces W001. No. Will it be applicable for the other DCs 002? It will give you an error. Okay. So in case of individual assignment, what I can do is, like, I can maintain this to the reference site /n refsite. We had seen this in the one of the site functionalities video. In the reference site, I had assigned this WRDC to the other DCs W001 to W110 for this assortment. Okay, now I am going to create a listing for that material for this reference DC WSP4 WRDC. Okay, /ME21N. Now I am going to W002. Yes, even though I didn't maintain the assortment or listing explicitly for this site 002, the system draws or refers the listing conditions from its reference site WRDC. So this example has additionally demonstrated the functionality of the use of reference sites in the mass maintenance of master data. Hope you find this video useful. If you like it, please like it, share it with your friends, and you can leave your feedback and comment in the comment section below. Don't forget to visit my blog. Have a good day.